when you join a new computer to the domain, it automatically gets placed into this computer folder. This is under our domain. In this folder, it gets placed here. But what if you want to change it? What if you want to move it into a more specialized OU, organization unit? So as we can see, we have OU US East. We also have US North. In these two OUs, there are special computers inside of the different OU. In US East, we have workstation, and in US North, we have servers. So basically, there is no computers under our server and workstation now. So let's go ahead and move the workstation in this main computer and move it to one of our OU. There are two ways to do that. You can either click on this and drag it, drag and drop to one of the OU that you want. For example, into the US East workstation, you will receive Active Directory Domain Services message. It's a warning that's asking you, do you really want to do this? So we don't want to do this now, so let's click on no. So that's one of the ways to move it. Another example is you can just right click on that new computer that is being joined to domain and go to move and look for the OU, the organization unit that you want to place that computer into. For example, let's put it in US East under workstation. So once you select the location, you click OK. And as you can see, let's go and refresh our main controller. So click on refresh, go back inside the computer. As you can see, there is no more computer inside this. There's no more workstation or computer inside the default location. Now it's now inside our US East workstation. This is what we just did. But this is a big problem, because every time you add a new computer, it always go into this default location. What if you want to specify a specific location whereby you want to put new computers that you just add to the domain, and so apply different group policies to them? So we're gonna go and look at the way to do that. How do you do that? Say for example, if we want to make in the US North, we want to make this server, we make it the default location instead of computers. Go and click on server and right click on server. Okay, go to properties and go to attribute editor and look for distinguished name. So distinguished name, all right, double click on that, and you can see we can pick this path to be our default location each time that we add a new computer to this techakin.com. So let's go ahead and just right click, copy. So once you have copied the distinguished name, go into PowerShell and type in redir, redircmp space, use a double quotation and paste the path that you copied and close the double quotation, then press enter. You do that, you see the redirection was successful. Okay, and minimize this, minimize your PowerShell, and so we have now made US North server our default location. For example, for now there is nothing in this location. Let's refresh. So there's nothing in server location. Let's check computer. There's also nothing in computer location. So let's go and add a new server and to test that out. So let's go to a new computer. This is a Windows 7 server that is not joined to the domain yet. So let's go and add this to the domain and see where it's placed in the domain. So click on start, right click on computer, go to properties. So for example, you see this server is actually still in work group and the name of the computer is DEV300. So click on change settings. On this page, click on change. We want to add this to the our TechAkin domain now. So click on domain and type in our domain name, TechAkin, TechAkin. So click OK. Enter the password and username for the administrator. So we add administrator and the password. Click OK. So as you can see, we have now joined this computer to TechAkin domain. You can see this message says welcome to TechAkin domain. Click on OK, click on OK, and click on close. Make sure you restart your computer or your server. So I will restart now. And then once we restart this, then we should now be fully joined to our new domain. But before that, let's go back into our domain controller. Let's go and check inside the computers, inside the default location. You will notice, refresh, you notice that nothing is hard inside the default location. Now let's go into the US North, refresh, and let's go inside our server. As you can see, the new computer is now added to server. Let's log back in into our Windows 7 that we just joined to domain. So using the domain user, so TechAkin/administrator. This person is a domain user. So put a password. Alright, as you can see, we have now logged into this Windows 7, which is now part of TechAkin domain. To find out, let's go here and let's go to start. Let's go to computer, click on properties, and as you can see, this Windows 7 Ultimate is part of TechAkin domain. To confirm, let's go back into our domain controller and let's look inside the default. You see inside the default location, nothing is there. Let's go into the we added into the OU server. Okay, this is the location, our OU is server, and the US North is the parent OU, and the domain controller, the main domain controller, and the name of the domain controller is TechAkin. So minimize this and let's refresh and click on US North and server. As you can see, we now have DEV300 added to every time we had a new computer, it's going to be added to inside of this server. So that's how to make sure you customize your default location. So we can now apply group policy to DEV300. So if you know of another way to join a computer to the domain and move it over to a specific OU, comment below and let me know how you achieve this, and see you next time.